Jerome, I don't know if you've had the opportunity to watch the expose. If you have, what are your thoughts?
I don't know what to say because, you see, what I saw in there, for me, I came in there with a very open mind, thinking that a lot of the things we've heard were mere charges against people that people didn't like. But on the evidence of what we have seen, my opinion is this. If Ghana is a country that cares about our integrity, the Football Association, there are too many people in there who have serious integrity questions to answer. Because I cannot, for instance, believe how a referee could take a goat and manipulate a match to the extent that even when he was traveling somewhere, he needed to cancel the trip, look for a place where they can kill the goat, and then make sure that, I mean, that selfish desire he has is satisfied. Referee Suka, we talked about him last year. People didn't believe us. I, for instance, then I was with Kotoko Express. We blacklisted him because that performance he showed that day was just too bad. And we've seen it here that he was influenced. I think that where we've gotten to, if the football people at the FA are very serious, everybody mentioned in this expose must be questioned.
Some have also suggested that the whole association, there's a need for us to have a total overhaul. Do you support that?
Yes, of course. I mean, if you have 66, as many as 66 referees, being compromised, then you don't have a football league. Because as we are playing the Xylophone Cash Premier League now, we have 120 referees. What we have seen from the video is that as many as more than half of those referees are the type that you can influence. So how then do we go on? I feel that this is an embarrassment to us as a football country. We have to thank Anas for going that deep to bring what some of us have suspected but had no evidence to support. Here we have the evidence, and I think that it is something that is so disgraceful. And I am looking at how people are going to rationalize this. I cannot even justify a lot of the things I have seen in there.
Let's limit the discussion to the FA president. In the video, we saw him packing as much as $65,000 in a polythene bag, which was showed clearly. Now, some have called for his resignation tomorrow morning. Would you call for that to you, Jerome?
To be honest, if I was the FA president, I would lay down the job this evening. Because, I mean, I care so much about my integrity. And see, before the video, we were told that the FA president was trapped and has led him on to say certain things. But watching the video today, I would say the FA president gave himself away. Because, a lot of the things that he said, I cannot even believe it. But I'm saying that he gave himself away too much. I mean, how do you rationalize the situation where, a company will be formed and then an agency, it's created as if it's coming from someone outside the FA, only to learn here that it is indeed people in the FA who is doing that. It's not good for our football.
Thank you very much, Jerome Autry. So we just spoke to Jerome Autry, formerly of Kotoko Express, but now with Dreams FC Communications.